Now, he was elected in August 2017 at the age of 23, the youngest ever Kenyan member of parliament. He was famously identified with a grey sweater he wore everywhere he campaigned. Although the odds were stacked against him, today, John Paul Mwirigi is the member of parliament for Igembe South constituency, Meru County, which we feature him on Success Factor tonight. 2 p.m. Thursday afternoon, a young man makes his way to Parliament.
The first time you actually sat in the House, how are you feeling? Were you intimidated? Were you overwhelmed? How did you feel? The first sitting.
The first sitting, I was not able to know how I can do things. Mm-hmm. That is why I consulted Mheshimiwa Cheboi, the Deputy Speaker, to show me how they normally operate.
At 23 years of age, John Paul Mwirigi was elected MP Igembe South constituency. We catch up with him a year and a half later.
I turned 24 last year, 25th this year, January 7th.
3 years ago, he worked as a casual laborer at Igembe Tea Factory.
I was just carrying logs and even offloading tea trucks. So I was getting something there around 350 shillings. That is what I was getting in a day.
He reminisces on conversations with his late father, who before his death had encouraged him to give politics and indeed leadership a try.
My dad was encouraging me from the one call. He was telling me, if those other men they can, what do you require for you to campaign?
The old man's vision would soon be realized as his son took to the ground campaigning after his father's death. John Paul Mwirigi had all the odds stacked against him. He was too young, did not belong to any political party, was broke, and had no political experience.
You are not. You do not have a permanent job where you are employed. You do not have any cash. Your family, you do not have even a vehicle to use during campaigns. So it was somehow difficult all the way through.
He stood as an independent candidate, and with the little he had saved from his meager earnings at the tea factory, he carried out a grassroots campaign, canvassing his constituency door to door.
Traversing, using by foot. That is how I was moving my constituency. And that is why many people of the constituency decided to side with me.
John Paul would later beat his nearest opponent in the election by garnering 76% of the total votes cast.
I was not surprised when this happened, because on 27th August, I told my people that tomorrow I will be the Member of Parliament of this constituency.
Soon after he was elected, President Uhuru Kenyatta promised to buy the independent MP a car.
When I was coming to be sworn in, I used the Nissan from Maua to this place. Then after State House, I walked out by foot. The president came to parliament to address the parliament. That is when we met with the president here. Then he told me that, John Paul, you are in my place and you came by foot. Why didn't you tell me that you do not have a vehicle or you do not have a car to use? So this is the place where he promised me that he will give me a vehicle.
So what has he been up to as Member of Parliament Igembe South?
I had promised that I will just go and seek a market for them where they can be selling their bananas. And I proceeded to the Twiga companies where I went and seek them to come and buy bananas from my place. I decided to have a common date when we can meet with the host student. They apply for the bursaries. Then after applying the bursaries, we sort out the names. Then we give the bursaries. Then I had promised that when I will get this job, I will be supporting the less fortune using my own salary. And for now, I have 11 students who I'm sponsoring.
But even as he talks of a first busy year in office, talks of his arrogance started sneaking into conversations and tabloids a few months after he was sworn into office. Skeptics now saying he is becoming uncontrollable.
Defeating some guys with a lot of money and you're using or spending nothing, they cannot leave you like that. And at the same time, though, these people, they will want to overshadow what you are doing. So that is why they normally collude with those bloggers, so that they can write something which is negative about me.
I ask him how his seniors in the 12th Parliament received him.
It was totally different from my expectations and from what I heard from other people, saying that when you are young and when you are a new person, you face challenges because those seniors will not maybe be giving you opportunity, or they will not show you how you can conduct yourself in the parliament.
Away from the august house, away from the leadership tags, he holds family dear.
I had promised to build for my mom a house after this success. That is what I did. I started doing.
At the time he was elected to parliament, he was in his third year at Mount Kenya University, pursuing a Bachelor of Education degree specializing in history and Kiswahili.
We'll be graduating this year on 12th July. That is when I will be graduating. But I will be having a very big function in my constituency the same month, so that I can tell people, you elected me while in school and now I have completed one level and still I'm still pursuing to go to another level.
So what does power do to a 23-year-old? How is he handling it?
When I was elected, many people expected me to change. John Paul, I have not changed. It is only the status which I've changed, and it is okay with the job. Thank you very much. Santi.
This is the story of Igembe South Member of Parliament John Paul Mwirigi, who has earned a place in Kenya's history books as one of the youngest ever elected members of Parliament.